Rockingham County District Attorney Philip Berger, Jr. held a press conference on Monday, September the 19th, to announce the formation of a Rockingham County Regulated Metals Task Force, whose purpose is to address the growing number of copper and metal thefts in the Rockingham County area.
The purpose of us being here today is to announce the formation of a task force to deal with regulated metals, typically known as copper. Copper thieves here in Rockingham County take an inordinate amount of our resources from not only law enforcement but the prosecutor's offices. And what we're here to do today is announce sort of a three-pronged approach to attacking this issue, and all will be addressed by the task force. The first concerns sharing of information. Now, the law enforcement offices here in Rockingham County and the DA's office do a very good job of working together as it is. We share information in investigation files on a regular basis, and they do a very good job. But what we want to do is we want to focus those efforts on copper thieves in particular, because it is a growing problem here in Rockingham County. The next part of the task force is to educate businesses and to help them become compliant if they're not, or come into compliance or remain compliant with the state's laws on regulated metals. It's fairly strict, intensive regulated industry, and we want to help the businesses stay in compliance with those laws. And then the final portion of the task force will be prosecution end, the end that I deal with and my office deals with. We have a prosecutor who will be dedicated to copper thieves, and we will pursue a just result for those individuals who are charged with or identified by law enforcement as especially problematic in that area. And in Rockingham County, a just result will include jail time. So that's a basic overview of the task force. Each of the law enforcement agencies has identified someone from their department to be a part of this task force, and look forward to working not only with each other on a continued basis, but with the community to try to address this problem. Be happy to answer any questions.
You say jail time, so you're very serious about this.
Yes. Yes. In Rockingham County, we will pursue jail time as for anybody that's been identified by law enforcement as a problem in this area.
How much jail time are we talking?
Well, it depends. You know, structured sentencing basically sets people up in a grid, and the amount of jail time depends on their prior record level.
Did you have a prosecutor solely for that before this?
We did not.
Okay, so this is the first.
Okay. Bill, kind of give us the number of cases you guys see here in Rockingham County, maybe off the top of your head.
I think what law enforcement sees, and they can speak a little more directly to this, but about 30 cases a month come in to the various agencies, and those cases at some point or another make their way into our office. Since the beginning of the year, we've probably had about 20 defendants involved in those cases, and while it may be one particular defendant, that defendant is often responsible for 10, 15, 20 cases.
And what are you seeing around the county?
Well, one of the primary crimes that we see is people stealing air conditioning units or parts of air conditioning units. We had a guy who stole metal carts from one of the supermarkets. So wide and varied, but you know, mostly air conditioning units. Thefts from construction sites, copper at construction sites, any number of ways thieves come up to steal things.
What's the message you're trying to send to them right now?
Take your business somewhere else.
What can you tell us about the gentleman that you're giving us the DVD on?
The DVD that you have is of a person named Jeffrey Thomas. Jeffrey Thomas was involved in an investigation by the Sheriff's Department. The Sheriff's Department did an excellent job in investigating this his series of crimes. I believe he had somewhere in the neighborhood of about 10 to 15 thefts and crimes associated with those thefts. The information on the DVD concerns the theft of an air conditioning unit at Lira's. It's a business out on Highway 29. And basically what he does is he hooks his truck up to an air conditioning unit and rips it out of the ground and the side of the building. You know, in addition to the loss that these businesses suffer from the damage to the air conditioning unit and replacement of the air conditioning unit, there's the cost associated with the damage to the structure itself. and Lyra's was particularly damaging. I think Mr. Thomas owes total restitution not only to Lyra's but to the other industry businesses of about $33,000.
What's happened to him?
He's currently in prison.
For how long?
14 to 17 months, and then he has some additional probationary time hanging over his head.